So I'm looking at the line on Oklahoma, Texas. 1.5?
Is that right?
Whoa. Hang on. So I'm seeing two. I'm not understanding. I see 1.5, and then I see, I'm sorry. I need the context in. 11.5.
I missed a one there.
I was going to jump all over that for a conversation. Okay. I can see that.
Which is still interesting to me when you look at that game in a neutral site being 11.5, and then you look at Oklahoma hosting Nebraska. So you take from a comparative perspective, you know, the odds makers think that maybe Texas is only about a, you know, when you account the home field advantage and the for Oklahoma against Nebraska, you know, when you think about that, you think maybe that the odds makers think that Texas is only about a 4 or 5 point better team than Texas right now. So, I mean, it's obviously at this point in the year, it's for, you know, for guys like me and you to kind of discuss and think about and, you know, wonder kind of what's in the thought process there. But yeah, I mean, I think that's very interesting to think about because, you know, Texas is a team that, you know, a lot of people don't really know what to think about, you know, in terms of kind of the predictions and prognostications. And I think a lot of people think obviously that they've got a lot of talent there. They're going to be good. I believe a seven or eight win team a year ago. And then, and then you bring in Sarkisian and the, you know, the talent that they got there, they certainly will be there. But, you know, Nebraska has a much easier schedule leading up to Oklahoma than Texas does. And I know it's a little bit further down in the schedule, but, you know, Texas, they go to Arkansas and then they host Louisiana the opening game of the year. And then they do go to TCU before that game. So, you know, Texas will be a little bit more battle tested, I think, than Oklahoma will coming into that game. When you see with those three teams, and Oklahoma really has, you know, they have Nebraska and they have Tulane, and I think they'll play West Virginia and Kansas State before that game happens as well. So, but yeah, it's interesting. It always seems like early on the Oklahoma Texas line is a little bit larger than you know what we would think of that it would be, but then, you know, it tends to go down a little bit once you get to game week.